Yo, champs in the making, Star Meister here. Episode 73 of Pokemon Journeys entitled Commander Pikachu, Head Forth Tairetsu has recently aired, and we'll be discussing the rundown and analysis of the episode. At the end of the video, we will give the episode a rating from 1 star to 7 stars. Without further ado, let's get started. The episode kinda begins in Cerise's lab and the narrator tells that the Pokemon are as lively as ever. Yes, really lively. Then, as Ash and Go do their daily task of feeding their Pokemon, Ghost Raichu teaches Grookey on how to fall in line. This reminds Professor Cerise about Falinks, which triggers Ash and Go to fly to the Galar region to see one. In Galar, Ash and Go begin their Falinks expedition, and along the way, Go catches a Galarian Stunfisk, which is a great scene. I think its introduction was done well, showing its ability to camouflage in order to catch its prey. Also, I love that Ash immediately recognized it to be a Stunfisk. Silent Return confirmed. After some exploring, they finally encounter several groups of Falinks. One group, however, doesn't look like they're in a good coordination. Then the cutest boy tries to play with them, triggering the Falinks to attack. Pikachu tries to defend with Thunderbolt and this causes the Falinks to be separated. So Ash heads on to gather the members while Go chases after the leader. On the other side of the story, we have a cute little Eiscue who got lost from his friends in the middle of the sea. As he's trying to find his home, he's faced with several inconveniences that brought him to various places. I don't even know how to describe this, basically, Eiscue was treated as a punching bag this episode. Going back to the Falinks. In Ash's end, since the Falinks don't have the leader with them, they appoint Pikachu as their leader and followed him wherever he went, much to Pikachu's dismay. In Go's end, he and his Pokemon teach the leader Falinks on how to confidently lead a squad. Silent Return confirmed again. Ash and Go finally reunite, and the Falinks begin to form a good coordination. Seriously, I don't know if I should treat Falinks as singular or plural. Not long after, Eiscue reaches the place where Ash and Go are, and then it engages in a battle with the Falinks. Obviously, Falinks wins the battle and decides to stay with Go at the end of the episode. Then, we see Eiscue getting wrecked again until it somehow manages to reach its home just by floating. So for my thoughts on this episode, I think it was okay. It's just your average filler episode. It had some funny parts. I genuinely laughed every time Grookey, Pansir, Panpour, Raichu, and Cinderace would fall in line behind Pikachu. Eiscue's adventure was pretty enjoyable too, but I feel like the intersection of the Eiscue plot and the Falinks plot wasn't good. I don't think Eiscue was the best Pokemon that Falinks could have beaten in order to prove that they are well coordinated, because instead of being satisfied with Falinks' development, I just felt bad for Eiscue. Also, I don't think Eiscue's ending was handled well. They didn't even show how he returned to its home. I wish this was separated into two episodes. But I would say the best thing about this episode is probably the weather. I love the gloomy and cold atmosphere, it felt so comfy to watch. Overall, the episode's plot and the direction felt off, but it was still entertaining to an extent, but not original series entertainment level. With that, I'm giving this episode a rating of 3 stars, it's mediocre. That's it for my review on the episode 73 of Pokemon Journeys. Comment down below if there's anything I missed. With everything said and done, I hope you all enjoy watching the Pokemon anime and become the most powerful trainer in the world! Thanks for watching and gotta catch ya later!